How y'all feeling today? This is Coach Reg back on deck with a life changer for y'all today. This might change the way you look at many things, yourself, your children, your parents, everything, when you understand this information. Now, before we get started, like, comment, subscribe right there and hit the notification bell so you can get the alerts on these life-changing, mind-thinking, shifting videos that I'm about to start making even more and more. Now, you ever think about, would you eat before you got here? What a question. How were you developed in the fetus mode? You ever think about why your children may be a little different, maybe tougher to deal with than you were, or tough to process information, maybe why you were? Well, this could possibly help you out with that. And if you don't have any kids, or you're thinking about having more kids, this can help you prevent a problem that is very important. Now, everybody is a seed before we get here. You're a seed which is fertilized into the egg, the soil, right? Cool. Let's think about the condition of the seed and the soil before you get here. Now, if you plant in the garden and you plant in bad soil, what's going to happen to that seed? It will grow, but it could grow on some chemical GMO type stuff. Think about you. Have you grown GMO? Have you grown GMO? And how do you fix this problem when it does happen? If someone is born with a mental defect, it is the responsibility of the child's parent to ensure they are under the right settings to be able to procreate, or you must almost ensure that your child will come out with some physical or mental defect that you have contributed to. Without this information, most will be procreating the wrong way, totally responsible without knowing they could have prevented this. We say ignorance is bliss. This is not blissful ignorance. This is basically not our fault in many ways, because many of us, or 99% of us, were not taught that before you procreate, there are certain situations you should not procreate under, and times you should not procreate as well. Otherwise, there will be dire effects to your children. And it could be how you got here and why you also struggle as well. Now, many, many years ago, when people had culture and rules before they were procreating, they would make sure they were under the right settings, and they would not do it if those settings were altered. The best bet is to have this information that I wish I would have had before I chose to procreate myself. But for many of you that have children that seem to struggle or are weaker children, more prone to violence, outbursts, behavioral issues, more sickness, etc., this will put things into perspective to you for why this may have occurred. Now, I know it's easier to blame all this on the food, like we always like to do, but look a little bit deeper than that. Now, the child shows signs of many defects after the age of 8. They're fully developing, their mind is developing a little bit better, and normally if something is pre-existing, it's going to start to show around the age of 8. Many children have problems with education and learning because the children who are conceived in an imbalanced way cannot receive the things and teachings easily because their mental is a little bit altered. I'm gonna go into about 6 different things you should think about before you choose to procreate, because many of us are procreating highly irresponsible. Now, number 1, do not conceive a child during a hurricane or other violent storms, because it will lead to a child with low resistance to disease. Do not conceive a child when either parent is extremely tired. The child will always be weak and sickly with little resistance to disease. 3, do not conceive a child if either parent is drunk or alcoholic at the time of conception. A child conceived under these conditions will be born with a liver condition, which will result in nervous conditions and mental problems. 4, do not conceive a child during times of battle or war. This also applies to different types of battles, such as struggle for power, office politics within a corporation, or like people who are just running a business, you have problem with family and friends, any beef or issues that you have with anybody, that is not the time to procreate, because everything is chaotic and you'll have that kind of child. 5, do not conceive a child during sunset, otherwise the child will have bad eyes. 6, do not conceive a child when the parent is under the influence of drugs or any medication, otherwise the child will have nervous or mental problems. This also applies to smoking as well. Now, after hearing this, maybe you're upset or you feel someone would have told you this before, but I can guarantee the school system and society isn't fueled by the same. It is fueled by the functionally insane, which would like you to be a complaining state with no action in an unbalanced state. That is why they thrive. Your responsibility is to ensure your Geno generation thrives. So take this info and pass it down the line so the next Genos will be better off. All right? You have this information. Take it. Use it responsibly. Make sure your seed is good before you put it in that soil, because a bad seed can mess up some good soil as well. But in many cases, we have a bad seed full of GMO food. We have bad soil full of GMO food come together and make a GMO baby. All right? You must be responsible, not just wrapping it up and everything, because when you decide to have a baby, you must make sure you are in the right state. You cannot be under influence of anything. Clean body, mind, spirit. Make sure you're doing what you gotta do. Get the best products in the world. Keep on feeding yourself the right stuff, and you'll be in a better state to be able to have children by supplementing and eating the right way for your spirit, your physical, your vessel. All right? I love y'all. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit the notification icon right there. I love y'all. I'm gonna see y'all soon. Until the next one, peace.